And your life is protected. And your life is preserved. Because the Almighty God Himself, He is on your side. And nothing will destroy or defeat you in Jesus' name. Preservation in the shelter of the Father. All you need to do is come into that shelter by faith. And when you are in that shelter by faith, everything that the devil is trying to do, everything is going to be destroyed because you come to that shelter. In Psalm 61, Psalm 61, and we're looking at verse 3, for thou hast been a shelter for me. A shelter. You come into the shelter of the Heavenly Father. You come into the shelter of this Almighty God. And in that shelter, your life is protected. Your life is preserved. You'll never be the same again in Jesus' name. But thou hast been a shelter for me and a strong tower from the enemy. I will abide in that tabernacle forever. I will trust in the covert. I will trust in the covert of thy wings. I pray that today you will experience that in your life in Jesus' name. Psalm 17, I'm reading from verse 8. Psalm 17, verse 8. Keep me as the apple of the eye. Hide me under the shadow of thy wings. You'll be hidden today in that shelter, in that shadow of the wings of the Almighty God, from the wicked that oppress me, from my deadly enemies who come, who compass me about. The Lord has done it already. Psalm 63. In Psalm 63, we're looking at verses 7 and 8. Psalm 63 verse 7, because thou hast been my help, therefore in the shadow of the wings will I, of thy wings will I rejoice. You will rejoice. I said you will rejoice because you come into the shelter of the Lord Himself. Psalm 91, now he that dwelleth, I will dwell there. I said I will dwell there. When you become converted, you are born again, you are a child of God. And then you remain inside that shelter. And you remain inside the protection. It says, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Will you be there? I said, will you be there? I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In him will I trust. Surely, any doubt today, any unbelief today, it says, surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler. He will. And from the noisome pestilence, he shall cover thee with his feathers. Under his wings shall thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and thy buckler. His truth shall be what? Tell me out loud, shall be thy shield and thy buckler, and thou shalt not be afraid of the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. They'll never come near you again. They never get to you anymore. There's protection, there's preservation. In the shelter of the Father, when you become born again, you come to the family of God and you dwell and abide in the shadow, in the shelter of the Almighty. I'm telling you, according to the word of God, there is no doubt here. You're going to be preserved and protected in Jesus' name. Number 7, 1,000 shall fall by thy side and 10,000 at thy right hand. But, you know what people think? Hey, this one kills so-and-so, this one kills so-and-so, that one kills so-and-so. And the doctors told me, what I've got is this thing that killed this, this, and that. How many people the doctor tell you he has seen that that thing killed? Maybe 5, maybe 10, maybe 20, maybe 30. Not up to 1,000 yet, there's nothing to worry about. Not up to 10,000 yet, there's nothing to worry about. Even when 1,000 has fallen by this side and 10,000 by the other side, it will never come near you. I said it will never come near you. The proclamation of the Lord for you is life and not death. Because Jesus Christ, your Lord and your Master, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, He is the life and the resurrection. And that life that comes out of that resurrection of Jesus Christ will come upon your body here. And you will never be the same again in Jesus' name. I'm going to read that verse again in verse 7. 70,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come near me. It shall not come near me. Only with mine eyes shall I behold and see the reward of the wicked, because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. There shall no evil befall thee. There shall no evil befall thee. You can walk the length and the breadth of your country. There shall no evil befall thee. You can get to the high position that many people are competing for. There will be no evil that will befall thee. You can go to your village and then walk in the day and move around in the evening. There shall no evil befall thee. And in your church here, there is liberty. There is liberty for every child of God, preacher, pastor, teacher, whoever. You walk anywhere, this is your Father's land. This is our Father's territory. And we who are preachers and leaders, you don't fear the faces of people. Anywhere you walk, everywhere you go, there shall no evil befall thee in Jesus' name. Neither shall any plague come near thy dwelling, for he shall give his angels charge over thee to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against a stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and the adder. I will tread upon the lion and the adder. I will tread upon the lion and the adder. I will tread upon the lion and the adder. I'm going my way. I'm going to do my work. And while I'm going, there's some lions and the adders and the poisonous snake on the ground. I don't look at them and say, hey, there is danger here. I must run back. Keep on walking. I say, keep on moving. And keep on going. Because while you're going to your business, and you're going to the ministry, and you're going to do what the Lord has called you to do. And they say, hey, there are lions on the road. Keep on walking, keep on moving, keep on going. Thou shalt tread, thou shalt tread, thou shalt tread upon the lions and the adder. And then it says over here, and the dragon shalt thou trample on the feet, because thou hast set thy love upon me. Therefore, I will deliver him. I will set him on high. Because he has known my name, he shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. He will be with you. I will deliver him and honor him. Now tell me, what is that in verse 16 there? In verse 16 there? In verse 16 there? With long life. We still have many more years to go. I said we still have many more years to go. Many more years to evangelize. Many more years to hold retreat. Many more years to preach. Many more years to organize programs. Many more years to live for the glory of God. And with long life will I satisfy him. I will show him. Show him what? My salvation. Rise up and trample upon all those things. Rise up and tell the Lord, today is a day of victory. Here we have authority. Here we have power. Here we didn't come to play.
That you have been blessed with this powerful message. Our address is at the bottom of the screen. I believe you will join us one of this Sunday to worship together. Thank you. God bless you. Let us pray. Our mighty Father, we glorify you, Lord, and thank you, Lord, because of this powerful message. I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, you will touch those people who are in need of salvation, those people who are in need of prosperity, those people who are in need of healing. And by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, they will give testimony because of this message. In Jesus' name we pray.
Say it one more time, say, oh, 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 Lord.